Like breakfast without Petra, this show also has no sex appeal. It's Jono and Ben at 10.
To Jono and Ben at 10. I'm Ben.
And I'm Jono. And up there, ladies and gentlemen, about to break the sound barrier is Guy Williams!
You know how I said I wanted to break the sound barrier, guys?
Yes!
I don't want to break the sound barrier anymore, guys.
Oh, do it, you pussy!
Come on, Guy, you promised.
I'm very nervous.
Jump!
I can't
jump.
Do it, I can't do it. Oh. I'm pussying out, I'm sorry.
Well, unlike Guy Williams, this week, extreme athlete Felix Bumgardner decided to test out...
You don't know his name, do you?
I don't know his name, I just see Bumgardner. Decided to test out...
Not Bumgardner.
Decided to test out if Red Bull actually gives you wings.
The professional daredevil known as Fearless Felix has become the first skydiver to break the sound barrier.
Wow, and apparently the word is he wasn't even doing a stunt, he was just trying out Jetstar's new Super Saver Fest.
Screw you, Felix, I make history every day, I just clear it before someone else uses the computer, mate.
Let's not forget about...
Holy shit!
...the free-falling pioneer...
Guy!
...who tried this over the champion years ago.
His helmet's gone, guys! He's broken. He's lost oxygen! He's a man down!
As I was saying, the free-falling pioneer who was first to break the sound barrier.
Shit, that was realistic. I can think we can prove that Red Bull doesn't give you wings, guys.
Guy Williams, ladies and gentlemen.
That cost us $3,000 to film that. It was definitely worth it.
But old Felix, what's his name? He wasn't the only sportsman to wear blatant sponsorship this week. The All Blacks were doing it, right?
Yeah, and it's always difficult when someone comes and slaps a logo on your shirt, as we found out this week.
They're going to become the three most important letters in New Zealand since STI.
And today we're out there spreading the good word, much like Brian Tamaki, except we're actually not getting paid anything for this.
Why are we actually doing this? I thought you were Simon. Sorry.
How much are you paying us for this?
Oh, that's right.
We're the team they didn't want.
Mate, we did it. We won the World Cup, mate.
That was quite enthusiastic.
He's down with AEIG. Yeah, you're going to
win. We won the World Cup. Ba-dum.
First on you.
Really?
First on you. Good on you. Thank you so much.
You haven't got AIG sponsorship on there, so you know.
Modernise the shirt. Would you like to buy that one?
That would be like probably 40 million.
Adam Thompson, All Black, is sitting around the corner having a coffee.
Yeah.
I mean, you know it, we know it.
Hey, mate, good luck to see
you. Adam, mate.
Yeah.
Good luck with the season.
Yeah.
Sorry, nice to see you, mate.
Yeah, man.
Love you, mate.
Good on you, guys. See you, guys.
Nailed it!
Nice work, mate.
Yeah.
Come on.
Thanks, man.
It was good.
Let's
take the Adam Thompson is going to kick our asses about now when he's just seen that.
But AOG sponsorship hasn't stopped with the All Blacks. Today, they just announced they're going to be on New Zealand's most famous jersey. Check it out.
Such a great deal, that one.
Oh, classic.
And another corporate sponsorship news, the National Bank has replaced the horse with a brand new actor in their commercials.
I know what you're thinking.
No, I'm thinking, what the hell is the dude from The Mentalist doing in an ANZ ad?
Are you a little bit bitter that the horse lost his job?
I'm very bitter. This is the worst bank scandal since the Auckland Savings Bank changed its name to ASB Bank. So now it's Auckland Savings Bank Bank.
Well, this week, Guy decided...
That's
a really good... And TSB Bank Bank.
Yeah.
And Kiwi Bank Bank.
Anyway, this week, Guy Williams decided to help out the National Bank horse by trying to get him his old job back.
Guy Williams television segment.
They're using your logo, mate.
How's it going? Just coming to suss out his old workplace. And do you think there'll be any work for Les in the future, or...?
Liz?
Yeah, Liz. The horse from the logo.
No, that's not Liz.
What? Don't try to say he's got the wrong horse. Liz is getting offended. It's all right, isn't it, Liz? Work and income, New Zealand. They've locked the door. We're trying to get the horse on the dole, but it's not working, mate. Calm down, mate. It's going to be okay, mate. We're going to find you a job and we're going to get you some food. It's okay. Could I please get a large lettuce? Do you just sell like a massive lettuce? We're just trying to find a job for Liz. Or like a huge bag of oats. Hello? Seems like there's no place for an unemployed horse anywhere, eh, Liz? So it's come to this. We'll neigh for hay outside the supermarket. Goodbye. This is the end.
Apparently the horse had a great time at Wins this week looking up personal details of other horses. By the way, Farlap was in some serious financial strife when he... Mark Todd's horse? Spent all his money on it, allegedly.
Time for this week's Jono versus Ben.
Scissors v Rock. Rock wins. Jono v Ben. Who wins?
And this week our challenge was to make a new TV show about Muppets.
We're already doing that, eh, Ben? Hey, eh, making a show with Muppets? Hey, be into that one, guy.
I'm above that.
Anyway, now this week you may have...
No, I'm not. You guys are losers.
You may have heard of a film called Ted, which is actually out on DVD next month, and it stars Mark Wahlberg and a talking teddy bear. Have a look.
White trash name, yes.
All right, Brandy, Heather, Channing, Brianna, Amber, Sabrina, Melody, Dakota, Sierra, Bambi, Crystal, Samantha, Autumn, Ruby, Taylor, Tara, Tammy, Lauren, Charlene, Chantel, Courtney, Misty, Jenny, Krista, Mindy, Noelle, Shelby,
Tammy Lynn.
Fuck! Well, this week I decided to give Ted a bit of a Kiwi flavour.
Are you that dude from Whale Rider?
What? I'm the pucker!
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
I'm Robert Ipparatini.
I'm Kimberly Crossman. Ooh, what's this from?
It's from a kid's show I used to present called Play School.
Cute! And who is that cute little bear?
Meet little Ted.
Are we going to lay down some group action or what?
Let me tell you about... You remember how you used to whisper everything in my ear?
Humpty's a fat buck.
Hey, you like that? Yeah, you like that, bitch? Hey? Hey?
Ready to knock? Turn the lock.
Who the hell is that?
Oh, I forgot to mention. My big brother's coming to stay for the weekend.
You're on a big Ted.
That's what the ladies call me. The ladies are mad at my head. Are you like me?
Hey, I met some.
What's her name?
Maori.
Okay.
Speed round. I'll rattle off some names. You buzz me when I get it.
I'll buzz you.
Manu.
Fuck!
Hang on, it looks like you just ripped off Ted, but with the guy from Play School.
Ben, it looks like that because it's exactly what I did, and you can vote for it on our Facebook page.
Now, coming up, we play a new game, John Key, all about three-way handshake. Even got the Prime Minister as well.
Ben has a crack at combining Sesame Street, and wait for it, guys, Shortland Street.
And our man-childs get up close and personal with Luke from the Bushwick.
But first, here is our clean-up of all the smut on New Zealand television this week.
This program is rated adult.
Now this week, big news, Jono, all about the British Prime Minister's cat.
Really?
Downing Street is playing down reports of a political catfight. Picture shows the Prime Minister's cat, Larry, taking on Freya, the Chancellor's feline who lives next door. Larry was brought into Downing Street to tackle a rodent problem, but he's been criticised for falling asleep on the job and possible Lib Dem cat tendencies.
What the fuck is going on with the news? What is the news?
Basically, like this show, it's 30 minutes too long, I think. It's the
moment. Cats always lay on their feet. That's a scientific fact. But it does raise the question, who's dropping cats upside down? I got a cat door recently. It's just a normal door. The cat doesn't know the difference.
Nice crowbarring in of cats, Jones. Anyway, things got awkward in Parliament this week when John Key finally admitted he knew something about the Kim.com thing.
Yeah.
Bit light on details on the whole Kim.com thing, but you know, there's a thing.
It hasn't been in the media for long. But things have been pretty awkward with John Key for a while now. I mean, there was this on the catwalk.
And then there was this at the press conference.
I've had a vasectomy. Well, that slowed things down. Any other question?
And our favourite awkward moment at the Rugby World Cup.
Now, given that next Tuesday is the year anniversary since that awkward handshake took place, Ben and I decided to use it as inspiration for this week's Action Men.
Welcome along to the John Key three-way handshake. Rules are as simple as the morons playing. Competitors must attempt to shake the same stranger's hand. And while a shake will see you succeed, a three-way groper will see you John Key.
Congratulations, very nice.
There's the hooter and they're straight into it. Oh, not surprisingly, these two striking out with a young lady and success not coming easily early on.
It's because we look like Jehovah's Witness.
Can see it.
Yes, and Boyce is on the board, and he's claiming soapy success.
Palm olive this morning.
Whoever.
Oh, and it's Boyce with a double, and Pryor is sick of it.
I feel like Tom Hanks in Philadelphia when he had AIDS, and I've got hand AIDS.
Well, perhaps he should use some protection, but no, he's got bareback, and he gets the shake, and Boyce is left groping. Or is it Pryor groping?
Thank you so much. Thank
All right, you're getting a little creepy. Hey, good day, sir. How you doing?
Hi there, mate.
But who's got him? Let's check the Purell hand sanitizer replay, and Pryor, he's got the grip, and he picks up number three. Boyce with a little trick called the shove and shake, and he pushes ahead, and Pryor's not happy.
Second half, took a good tumble there,
what a snake.
Well, Jono needs to keep a hand in this competition.
Shoelaces, mate.
And Jono does just that. Pryor ties it up with the laces.
Can only try that trick once.
Yeah.
He's figured out he doesn't actually have shoelaces.
No shoelaces.
Boyce now may have Pryor on the run.
This is ludicrous.
Pryor will need to pull finger. There's no handouts here.
I think it was AC/DC who once wrote a song called You Shook Me All Night Long.
Oh, looks like the Akka Dakka Sneak Attacker. A move first made famous by Jono just then.
Lock it in. Skateboarder extra points. And you're locked in. You're locked in.
Oh, this one looks contentious. We'll have to check the replay, and this one seems far too close to call. That'll be thrown back to the shaker.
Who's handing shaking right now?
Right. Yes. Oh, and it's Boyce going 5-4 over Pryor.
You're the Sally Ridge of this three-way. We're Sonny Bill and Jamie, my friends.
Oh, my God.
Jono starting to despair as we go into the penultimate round.
Pull her out there. Pull her out.
What's Pryor up to here? Oh, my goodness. That's a fistful of flour right in the face for Boyce. As we check the replay on that, you can see the flower. Pryor with a handful of it, and Boyce with a face full of it. Well, Jono's happy with that one, and a two-finger salute for Boyce.
Shake and bake.
And the scores are all locked up as we head into our sudden death celebrity shake round.
It's the tiebreaker for John Key.
Yep, and who better to decide than Paula Bennett?
Sorry, John Key. John Key would be the ideal person to decide the winner of this game.
He would be, and he's speaking at a function over there.
Ben, let's go to the function over here, mate.
Well, just who will grab this holy grail of handshakes and John Key with John Key? Boyce has the handout, but Pryor's gone late, and it's inconclusive.
How's
your day going?
Good.
Oh, no, and now they're having to engage in small talk. Well, this has been a complete disaster.
Who won that one?
I did, but I think all good conversation was the winner on the day.
Thank you very much to the Prime Minister John Key for playing that game. Unfortunately, he's forgotten all about it.
And Julia Gillard, Australian Prime Minister, was probably hoping that people will forget about this incident in India during the week. It's funny because she falls over in the ground.
Oh, ginger ale, all right?
Oh, Julia.
Shit, that was realistic. You can't even tell the difference. The budget on this show is amazing.
Now, before Lord of the Rings and Flight of the Conchords, the only New Zealanders the Americans knew were these guys.
Whoa!
Yeah!
Since we've been here in the WWF, we've had so much fun together, Cousin Lou.
And I thought you guys were the most embarrassing New Zealanders on television.
Anyway, in the 90s, the bushwhackers were our biggest export, along with beef and lamb. And this week, our man Childs went to catch up with one of them.
Roadies from Shapes, feeding you the man Childs.
They're more than just poor grammar. They're Jono and Ben at 10 years old.
Hi, I'm Lil Jono.
And I'm Lil Ben.
And today we are talking to Luke from the Bushwhackers.
Whoa!
Hello. You guys ate sardines and looked at each other. Did you lose a bet or what?
Oh boy, you eat those sardines in the morning and they give you the whoa, yay!
You used to lick each other's heads.
Yeah.
Is meningitis not a thing in the 90s?
Wow! I had to kill the germs, but I don't want to tell you what I killed it with.
Where are your teeth?
You want to hold them for me? You sure? You know what I'll do? I just got to put them over my ear here and keep them for on. Later on.
Did you get rich doing deals with the Tooth Fairy?
Now that's a good one, mate. Boy, I should give you a good lick for that one. What do you say? Whoa! Yay! Doesn't it taste lovely? Oh.
Did he actually lick you? Were you and Butch really that good, or did you just coast by on your good looks?
What do you mean, our good looks?
I think you should give him a licking. Yeah.
I think I should too. Yay! Tastes like sardines too, how about that?
You have competed in the WWF, NWA, ECW, FCW, and AWA. Are you disappointed you never competed in the OMG or KFC?
I'd love to compete in the KFC. You're making me feel hungry already, mate. And I'm getting a whoa! KFC! Boy, where's the nearest KFC around here, guys?
Down the street. You used to do a move called the battering ram. Can you use Little Ben to show us how it
work? Low five, guys. Too slow, no go. See ya. Whoa!
Now, the most disappointing thing about the Bushwhackers, they were in the WWF for 10 years, didn't save one panda.
Oh. You're confusing the World Wrestling Federation with the World Wildlife Fund.
Thanks for explaining that.
I was just explaining why the joke was shit. Apologise to the audience.
I'm really sorry.
Coming up...
Why did I agree with that? All right.
Coming up, Ben has a crack at joining Sesame Street and Shortland Street together in his Muppet TV show.
And I get punished thanks to your buddies at Nitro Circus.
But first, here's more smut that we had to clean up from New Zealand television this week.
This program is rated adult.
Okay, bring it around, bring it around, bring it slowly, slowly. Oh, fuck, no, 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 fuck, oh, fuck, shit, no, 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 fuck, oh, fuck.
Welcome back to Jono and Ben at 10. Now, we've all been following our favourite fictional family, the Countdown family, since the sad news. The dad got made redundant.
It's been a tough fortnight for him, but thankfully this week he is back to his chirpy self.
I need you to do the shop for me today.
Yeah. No problem. I'm on it.
So what, hang on, he's unemployed with an alcohol problem now?
It's a dangerous combination. And now he actually goes to Countdown drunk and harasses the shoppers.
What?
Hey, mate, I think you'll find it's only one per customer.
But if you think those ads are bad, have you seen that new ITM one?
No?
Have a look at this.
You know, I could have been an eye specialist.
I could have been a stomach specialist.
I could have been unemployed playing Xbox.
Could have been a heart specialist.
Doesn't that take like 25 years at uni?
I could have been a skin specialist.
Is that even a thing?
Once, I could have been a brain specialist.
No offence, mate, but I feel like brain surgery is a little bit more complicated than working at a...
Me? A tooth specialist.
At least get the name of the job right. It's called a dentist, you dumb motherfucker.
Wolfie, you right?
Time now for part two of Jono vs Ben, and this week we're making puppet TV shows.
Now, Big Bird, he's caught in the middle of the US presidential campaign, isn't he? So I thought I'd take his show and combine it with New Zealand's favourite medical drama. Make sense?
No.
No, it doesn't, but there it is.
What do we have here, nurse?
Well, doctor, the patient is incredibly violent and lashing out.
Looks like another monster brought to us by the letter P.
I'm so sorry, Mr. the Frog. The operation didn't quite go as planned.
Your son, he didn't make it.
He pretty much died as soon as we removed the hand from his ass.
Man, it feels good to be out of there.
You are one very lucky bird.
Not many birds fall in the deep fryer and live to tell the tale.
I'm sure that you will take amazing care of him, Mr. Sanders. Look, he did it again. He put his hands all over me during theatre.
What have I told you about inappropriate tickling?
I will get hands.
Dr. Ernie, sorry, I didn't realise that you were in. Dr. Bert?
Sesame Street, coming to TV's near and far, and put you number three.
Now, if you want to vote for my Sesame Street sketch, just get to our Facebook page, and of course it stars the lovely Kim Crossman too, doesn't it?
You just did that so you could spend the day with the lovely Kim Crossman.
Oh, whatever, mate. I don't notice attractive girls anymore since I got married.
Your wife's watching tonight, isn't she, Ben?
Absolutely, she is watching tonight. Yes. Yeah, hi, dear. Put the rubbish out.
Don't worry, mate. I put out the rubbish when I was around at your place earlier. Hi-yo!
Nailed it.
Anyway, it's time now for Ben to be punished after I've lost...
Is that not punishment enough?
No. 4 weeks in a row I've lost, so it's time for some redemption, my friend.
Yeah, and you got your mates from Nitro Circus did some live Angry Birds thing. Dumb idea.
So until next week, like the Ridges with no television crew following them round now, please do not forget about us. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next Friday.
Sucks. Didn't that take me to the circus?
Not circus, mate. It's the Nitro Circus. I've lost four of these punishments in a row, so I've decided to go big this week, Ben, by flying my mates from Nitro Circus over here.
They're not your mates.
They're my mates. Barry.
In joke, wouldn't get it.
It's very scientific, you know, like you look like...
There's a bit of natural physics in there, yeah. And so this looks about right. You stack it here and I'll hit the guy in the face here.
Really technical.
Top quality plastic. Yeah, shipped in from the States.
So that's going to protect your heart and your sternum. That's about it.
Also protect stormtroopers.
And then I just shoved a bunch of pads around to make everyone feel better, but I have no idea where they're going to land.
Blah, 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 die, heart attack, blah, 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 sign.
A lot of protection down below, and plus you've got a right of me flung at your face.
Not a lot of protection, there's no protection
underneath you.
Straight onto the concrete.
I think I'm going up top too. Which is probably the position I'd least like to go.
This could be the world's worst rubber band ping.
This is quite intimidating when he's all the way back there.
This is for freedom!
Oh, jeez. This is a dumb idea.
Freedom!
One, go!
It's a very dumb idea. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Fuck, fuck. Oh, my God.